So I'm the field CTO and principal architect at Anjuna Security. We are really here to help you guys understand why confidential cloud is really important in the way that we actually do enhancing privacy technology, as well as the simple fact that you should be running all your workloads within the Nitro Enclave environments. And so the reason why we do this is really focused around the simple fact that we want to provide an ability for you to lift and shift any type of applications into any cloud, and specifically the AWS Nitro, to get the benefit of isolated workloads, to provide data confidentiality, data integrity, and then to basically make sure that you can attest or build code integrity into the ways that you're actually deploying into the AWS environment. And this is really important when you think about the concepts of being able to provide a guarantee that your data is not being spied on by internal actors, external actors, and then giving you an ability to actually take a look at a security policy that can be implemented within your build process, and then not having to change the way you actually do your application deployments today. So what really makes Nitro very special, and specifically why we love working with Amazon on this, is the simple fact that it provides true isolation away from everything. So what you're going to get in an AWS Nitro Enclaves environment is you're going to have an EC2 instance, you're going to go ahead and enable the Nitro-enabled hardware, and then what we're going to do is we're going to provide a way for you to actually provide bidirectional communication, an at-rest layer, and using the in-use and actually the isolation of the actual Nitro Enclave chipset to be able to protect your application in real time. And this is to basically provide you a way so that no matter what type of application, whether it be a monolith, a microservice, that we can give you an ability to protect that information and have a guarantee around that because you know it's actually being isolated from the public internet. Now, what's really exciting about this technology is the simple fact that we've made it so that it's agnostic across the whole board. So regardless of how you have your applications deployed, regardless of how you're actually deciding to deploy this, we actually support all different types of configuration mechanisms, deployment models, as well as orchestration environments. And if you can take a look at the way that we kind of tier our application, we are becoming the unenforceable barrier that protects you in a way that allows the CSP provider to provide a great shared responsibility, isolating your workloads, and then on top of that, being able to run any type of application in the cloud without compromising your data security. Because ultimately, what we want to do here is provide a way to basically enable privacy-enhancing services and to protect your secure workloads. Now, one of the things that's very unique about the Nitro Enclave system is the simple fact that they give you a set of tool sets, but they don't always give you the complete pieces to make it work. So what we do in Anjuna Security is we make it easier for our customers to actually deploy into a Nitro Enclaves environment. So traditionally, without Anjuna, we'd have to take your application. You would have to actually build the application parts with SDK. You would actually have to build an Enclave intro file. And then you would have to deploy it on a Nitro Enclave to only get in-use protection. So you get the isolation with the Nitro Enclave environment. Now what we're doing is specifically making it easier for you so you don't have to make any code changes to be able to take your original application and deploy it on a Nitro Enclave to be able to get in-use, at rest, and in transit, and to be able to have it enabled by default at any given point in time. And this is what's really exciting for a lot of our customers, because there's a guarantee that we can give you that when you deploy that application, that the application is allowed to run within the Nitro Enclave environment. There's policies that enable it to communicate within Amazon's KMS system and build out IMA rules for you. And then on top of that, you're getting a default level security so that when you actually do deploy this in the AWS environment, that you can guarantee that the isolation is truly there. Now, if we go a little bit deeper into this, and as I was saying before, we not only provide the integration, the build tools, and the mechanisms to do this, but we also provide a network layer that allows you to communicate back and forth between a trusted and untrusted layer of the Nitro Enclave and the EC2 instance. And then we actually provide an at-rest layer, so we actually give you a file system that you can natively write to and gives you an ability to protect your workloads in real time. And this is really exciting because when you actually are taking your application from on-prem to cloud, you don't want to have to rethink the process, rewrite your deployment mechanisms, and then actually have to rewrite your application to work for a specific ecosystem. We basically provide a way to be able to do that in real time. Now, the great thing about the way that we kind of thought about this is about building a simplistic model so that we can build this isolation in conjunction with the AWS solution so that we can establish exclusive data controls that enable you to protect that data within that environment. We make it super simple by basically providing the build tools so that you can actually use it in real time. And then we provide a unified platform that enables you to basically protect anything on any cloud with the same methodologies and to be able to use the security by default and, in essence, making it easier for you to actually control your privacy-enhancing services. And when we look at kind of how we work with this ecosystem, we make it even more simplistic because we're using the AWS native services like KMS and the attestation policies to make it so that you can actually prove the measurements of your application that you're running. We can prove that the security of that environment is truly actually being isolated. And then on top of that, we provide monitoring capabilities built into the logging infrastructure of it. And we give you an ability to build policy management around the simple fact that we actually make it easier for you to define what's encryption, decryption, and what is allowed to access resources, which we call attestation. And this is really what's important around a lot of different use cases that we work with because of the simple fact that we want to make sure that when you're deploying a key management system, whether you're deploying a database application, that you're always going to have a security layer that's always enforced. And even if there's a human error specifically related to configurations, that we give you an ability to protect this in real time. So if we take a look at this specific use case around HashCard Vault, we're basically protecting every Vault system. We're protecting the in-transit layer. We're protecting that rest layer so that when you actually deploy your key management system in a multi-cloud strategy, that you're guaranteeing that those keys cannot be read by the cloud service provider, nor can an internal actor be able to access that without actually having the root token associated to it. And as we get deeper into the stack and the complexity of the information gets even more comprehensive throughout the whole environment, you know, the application, as it gets more complex, as you add more orchestration, we just become an in-phase layer that allows you to basically deploy with confidence every single time you deploy within these environments. And that's what's really exciting about this technology is we don't actually change how you do your deployments. We don't change the application. We just give you that default level of security that is always available. And even with human error within configurations, you know that's going to be put in place because it's a standard way of doing security within the AWS ecosystem. And on top of that, because of the way we've actually done these build utilities and how we actually protect these workloads, you know, we actually provide a lot of value add on top of the Nitro ecosystem. We work natively with the EKS environments. We provide comprehensive support for Kubernetes environments, even if you're running them within AWS. And then on top of that, if you're just using EC2 instances, we are giving you the ability to lift and shift your applications with very minimal work and to be able to do that with three easy steps. And that's what makes this really great from an actual technology perspective and the simple fact that you're always going to get those three-level protection and being able to protect this in real time. Now, think about this from a business perspective. We want to make sure that we are the most less impactful portion of your migration to cloud. So we want to make sure it's easier for you to actually justify this within your organization. How many of you guys would actually love to tell your CTO, your CIO, hey, you know, I can bring all our applications in the cloud with very little security risk, and then being able to say, hey, I can reduce our total cost of ownership by over half because I don't have to rebuild my application, I don't have to take on the technical debt, and then on top of that, I can make it even easier for you because I can guarantee the security of that actual platform. And so when we talk about business value in this environment, it's really about making sure that we make the best possible experience for the developers, we make it easy for security to understand, and then from a winning perspective, we make it so transparent that no one actually knows you're running Anjuna because everything's isolated within the Nitro Enclave environment. And that's what's really exciting about this product. And if you guys are interested in learning more and getting more in detail with this, our booth's right on the other side of this wall. Definitely ask for me, ask for one of my staff members. We'll do a demo for you. And thank you for your time. Thank you.